Thank you. That's an old Bill Monroe tune, and when we were doing the research for this record, we went back and listened to a lot of old recordings, and when you listen to Bill Monroe singing those songs and the emotion and the passion that comes back, it's pretty powerful. So picking up a song like Sit Alone in the Moonlight or something that Bill did, it really touches your soul and kind of grabs you back and pulls you back into the 1940s and the 50s when all this music started. We also found an old LP recording of the Coon Creek Girls. I don't know if anyone out there knows that group, but they were all women and they played bluegrass music way back when. And this was an LP that we had that had this next tune on it. It's an old time song called The Red Rocking Chair, but their version was particularly haunting. And because they were women, we listened and we loved what we heard. So this is our version of The Red Rocking Chair. And featured on it, let me introduce you to this fine fiddle player. She hails from Eastern North Carolina, where she teaches both violin and bluegrass fiddle. She's a Suzuki-trained violin teacher. She teaches in the Mark O'Connor American Violin Method. And she also plays with the Long Bay Symphony in the orchestra. She plays with the rock band. She plays bluegrass and old-time music. One of the most versatile musicians I know and have the honor to share the stage with. Please make welcome Miss Pattie Hopkins.
Thank you.
New Jersey. I did not know about bluegrass music. I actually was introduced to it 15 years ago when I moved to Raleigh, North Carolina. But I did have the good fortune of growing up listening to old country music on the AM station out of Sterling, New Jersey, 1590 with my dad and the Everly Brothers' Greatest Hits cassette tape, which was the only tape that my mother owned, and we drove around in our Chevy Caprice station wagon listening to that, and I think that's where I got my love of brother country harmonies, or sister country harmonies, as we interpret it.
Lynda can sing all the Everly Brothers songs in just in every harmony.
Yeah. All the words. My mom and dad are here tonight, and I'd love to shout out to them as a big thank you. Long time ago. Respect most are Hazel Dickens and Alice Gerard. Yeah. And we were driving out to Nashville last year that I.B.M.A. was in Nashville, Tennessee, representing Raleigh. We were out there to welcome people to our new city. They had already chosen Raleigh as a new host city, and we wanted to host a room at the after-hour showcase to let people know what a wealth of bluegrass there was here in Raleigh, North Carolina. So Pattie and I were driving out there by ourselves. We had to leave the boys from the Kickin Grass Band behind that time. And we thought, well, we're gonna showcase out there, and we're gonna showcase as a duo because the guys can't make it. And we learned this next tune on the drive out there. It's an old Carter family song that Hazel and Alice do, and we listened to their record, the Pioneering Women in Bluegrass record, over and over, and this is a song that they perform on that, and one we'd love to do for you tonight. This is called A Distant Land to Roam.
Thank you.
much. Thank you for spending the evening with us. We have maybe one more song for you. And we thought we'd unplug our instruments and come out front here. We're in a church tonight. One of the songs that Pattie and I put on our traditional duets record is a Mountain Gospel tune that we heard off on Hazel Gerard record. We'd love to sing that for you, and I think we're gonna maybe do it a cappella. This is, yeah.